Morning dear students, now we will discuss about the third topic for today's sessions, that is emphysema. So emphysema, that is usually results from distension and rupture of the alveoli due to the loss of elasticity of the lung tissue with the resulting air trapping. So for the bronchiolitis, we have discussed about the same topic, that is air trapping is occurring especially during expiration because of the narrowing of the airway and normal narrowing during expiration. So that's why air is trapped, and over a particular time again the elasticity is lost and leads to rupture. So this is about the emphysema. So the types of emphysema and the etiology go in hand in hand. So mainly there are four types of emphysema. So the first one is obstructive emphysema, second is compensatory emphysema, third one is congenital lobar emphysema, and fourth one is familial emphysema. So the first one is obstructive emphysema. So this is the same thing which we were discussing for sometimes, that is due to partial occlusion of bronchus or a bronchiole in case of atelectasis, bronchial asthma, lung infections, foreign body aspiration, etc. What happens? The air is trapped in the alveolus and it will be distended. Over a particular limit, it will be ruptured and it leads to obstructive emphysema. The next is compensatory emphysema, occurs when normal lung tissue expands to fill up the areas of collapsed lung segments, and it occurs in pneumonia, pneumothorax, etc. So what happens is when a particular area is collapsed or affected with pneumonia or pneumothorax, the normal tissue will start trying for compensating the affected part by increasing its expansion. So over a particular limit, this normal tissues also will go for rupture because of its increased function to compensate the abnormal or involved areas. So that is about the compensatory emphysema. The third one is congenital lobar emphysema. This is found in some neonates and young children, usually when they are with severe respiratory distress. So small children, when they are affected with severe respiratory distress, especially when the child is born preterm or normal, small babies, they will have respiratory distress and they will end up with congenital lobar emphysema. And the fourth condition is familial emphysema. So this is a inherited condition, so inherited as autosomal recessive trait. So that is about the familial emphysema. So we have discussed about four types of emphysema, that is obstructive emphysema, the second is compensatory emphysema, congenital lobar emphysema, and the familial emphysema. Next we can see the clinical manifestations are depending upon the area of lung tissue involved and how much area is involved. So progressive dyspnea can be the tachypnea, can be the cough, wheeze, chest retractions, cyanosis, and these are the manifestations of emphysema. And management, it is depending upon the cause of emphysema. Symptomatic management is usually done, oxygen therapy is required, some conditions bronchodilators will be administered to dilate the reduced radius of bronchus or bronchiole, then mucolytic agents to remove the secretions which is decreasing the radius of airway. Then antibiotics may be required to prevent the complications and also to treat the bacterial infections. And in congenital conditions, congenital lobar emphysema, usually what we do is lobectomy to decrease the complications in children. So this is about the management generally, and we will do routine care for the child. Rest should be given, proper position, increased oral fluid intake, and if it is not there, IV fluids or NG tube feeding will be provided. By adequate diet will be provided, avoidance of bronchial irritants or any other smoke or any other irritants which is complicating the condition. Chest physiotherapy, postural drainage, these breathing cuff exercises are provided to remove the secretions and also to prevent the other complications of emphysema. So this is about the emphysema. Hope you understood. Emphysema, that is a obstruction or any reasons which leads to the rupture of alveoli. So four types are there, and management is depending upon the type of emphysema. The next topic is empyema, or it is otherwise known as pyothorax. So in that term itself, py or pyothorax, so that is pus. So pus in the pleural cavity, pleural space, is the empyema. So you can see the pus. Empyema, it is a collection of thick pus in the pleural cavity. So it may be how the pus is entering the pleural cavity, or it is present in the pleural cavity. It may develop directly from lungs or from neighboring structure or through blood. So it can come from lung infections or any neighboring tissue or structure like bones, like intercostal area or any other area, or from blood like septicemia. From that also pus can enter in the pleural cavity. Incidence is very common in infancy. Small children are more getting pyothorax. Etiology, pus formation, definitely it is because of bacteria. So staphylococcus, pneumococcus, streptococcus, and another virus, that is Haemophilus influenza virus. These are the causes for pyothorax. And usually after pneumonia, lung abscess, pulmonary tuberculosis, chest injury, septicemia, metastasis spread from other supportive foci from distant lesions such as osteomyelitis. So these are the conditions after which usually this empyema occurs. Clinical manifestations, when you are observing, there will be any infection anywhere in the body. So when we are collecting the history, a history of any infection in the body, measles or staphylococcal infections can be there, and there may not be any typical signs for empyema in many children, but we can see growth failure, fever, diarrhea. Other than that, there will be some specific features like fever, cough, respiratory distress, chest pain, cyanosis depending upon the area of involvement, toxemia, loss of weight, clubbing if it is for a long term, then anemia and other features of malnutrition. If it is not treated for a longer period, it can happen. And the chest signs are diminished movement of affected side. When we are examining or auscultating the chest movements, there will be diminished sound on the particular area and movement on the affected side. Mediastinal shift to the opposite healthy side. Widening and dullness of the intercostal spaces can be the dull on percussion, diminished air entry. So these are the some of the chest signs. So clinical manifestations, it will be varying, and in many children manifestations will be very limited, and the growth failure and other problems will be observed in the children. Diagnosis, usually we will do chest x-ray and pleural aspiration or the pleural fluid will be taken for biochemical and bacteriological examination. Complications are bronchopleural fistulas, pyopneumothorax, lung abscess, purulent pericarditis, osteomyelitis of the ribs, septicemia, meningitis, and arthritis. So these are the some of the complications. Management is usually done with antibiotic therapy. So we have to start as early as possible, because main etiological factors for empyema is bacteria. So it has to be started as early as possible. Next is intercostal drainage. So usually we will keep a drainage system to remove the pus collected from pleural cavity.
Next is a surgical drainage. If there is severe respiratory difficulty and complications, we will do a thoracotomy to drain the pus from pleural cavity. So this is the management of embyema. So in today's session, we have discussed four conditions: bronchitis, bronchiolitis, embyema, and emphysema. And regarding embyema, that is a pus collection in the pleural cavity. And it can be from a local spread or can be from a distant spread. And the clinical manifestations are varying, and it is very uncertain. Clinical manifestations are the management is antibiotic and therapy and the removal of pus from the pleural cavity by intercostal drainage or surgical drainage. Thank you for kindly listening. Thank you very much.